Good morning and welcome to the second meeting of the Health, Social Care and Sport Committee in 2024. I've received no apologies for today's meeting. Our first item today is consideration of a document subject to parliamentary control, Draft Funeral Director Code of Practice. The purpose of the code is to set minimum standards for funeral director businesses in their care of the deceased and related procedures and behaviours. The Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee considered this document at its meeting on the 9th of January 2024 and made no recommendations in relation to this document. We will have an evidence session with the Minister for Public Health and Women's Health and supporting officials on the document. Once we have had all our questions answered, we will proceed to a formal debate on the motion. And I welcome to the committee Jenny Minto, Minister for Public Health and Women's Health, Elizabeth Sadler, Deputy Director of Public Health Capabilities, Joanne Tintal, lawyer, and Alexandra Wright, burial and cremation team leader, all from the Scottish Government. And we move straight to questions and Tess White.
Morning, Minister and team. Just my question is around cost and regulation. So I understand about care, but cost is also part of care. And recently in the press, it was highlighted that funeral costs are on the upward projectile, and you know, eye-watering figures of over £4,000 for a funeral, which is, and each funeral company can actually set their own fees. So you'll agree, hopefully, £4,500 is a lot of money, but also. What's known as pauper's funerals. So pauper's funerals is something that could be regulated, and the costs do vary and can vary for each area. And I've got some figures that they can vary from over £1,000 to Edinburgh figure that in Edinburgh is £683. There were, and my data isn't recent. The data that I've managed to find was in 2015. There were 549 pauper's funerals in Scotland, costing the public purse £500,000. So my question, Minister, is that something that can be looked at? If it can't be incorporated into this, can it be looked at by you moving forwards? Thank you.
Thank you, Convener, and thank you, Tess White, for that question. I took part in a discussion about, and actually a number of debates as well, about poverty and death. So it's something that is very much on my radar. And I was very pleased to hear at the discussion that I was at, the support that celebrants will provide people that may not be able to afford funerals. So that's not specifically with regards to this piece of code, but yes, it is something that I am absolutely aware of when we look at regulation and also licensing and things like that. I think it's also, though, important to point out that the Competition and Market Authority did a piece of work in 2021, and as a result of that, funeral directors are now required to have online or available when they're talking to bereaved families the costs of how much a funeral will cost, and they also are required to provide any information if costs have changed. I think it's also important to note that the Scottish Government has got a range of actions to support people in fuel poverty. And though that doesn't specifically sit within my remit, I'm happy to write to you to give you that additional information. But it is something that I am aware of, yes.
Thank you. Thank you, Convener.
Thank you. And can I thank the Minister for her answers there? I've had no indication that any other member wishes to ask questions, and so we'll move to agenda item 2, which is the formal debate on the document on which we've just taken evidence. Minister, can I ask you to speak to and move motion S6M11905?
Can I check, Convener, do you want me to read my statement in there, or do you just simply want me to move the motion?
As we're moving to the debate on the motion, then to read your statement and to move the motion, please, Minister.
Thank you for confirming that. I'm delighted to join you today to consider the draft Funeral Director Code of Practice, a significant milestone in the regulation of the funeral sector in Scotland. The draft code has been developed under the Burial and Cremation Scotland Act 2016, which provides a modern, comprehensive legislative framework for burial and cremation in Scotland. The death of a loved one will be, for many of us, one of the most difficult experiences we will face. Bereavement impacts on each of us in many ways. Funerals can fulfil a vital role in the grieving process, providing an opportunity to commemorate and celebrate life, but also to acknowledge the reality of loss. Funerals are organised at a time of extreme emotional vulnerability. If things go wrong with the arrangements, there can be lasting impacts. Funeral directors are entrusted to guide individuals and families through this challenging time. They directly prepare the deceased for viewing, burial or cremation, a trusted role with profound significance across cultures and faith systems. It is crucial, therefore, that when a person dies, funeral directors can be relied upon to deliver a highly compassionate, conscientious and professional service, which must maintain the dignity of the deceased and be respectful and sensitive to the bereaved. The draft code introduces minimum standards of care for the deceased and aims to establish and promote a common understanding of good practice. It will also be key to underpinning the statutory inspection of funeral directors in Scotland. It aims to safeguard against malpractice and help promote continual improvement in the sector, contributing to greater public trust and confidence in the services that funeral directors provide. Specifically, the draft code covers engagement of the funeral director and transfer of the deceased, care of the deceased and the premises used by the funeral director, planning the funeral service according to the wishes of the deceased and the bereaved, delivery of the funeral, dealing with complaints, business continuity and management risk. The draft code has been developed in close collaboration with the funeral industry and other key stakeholders, drawing on their experience and expertise to ensure the intended outcomes of the code are proportionate, pragmatic and justified. The code has been available in draft form on the Scottish Government's website since 2019 and has been extensively consulted upon. In addition to a full public consultation, focused engagement sessions took place with small, independent and rural funeral directors. Respondents were generally supportive of the draft code and its intentions. The feedback we have gathered has been instrumental in refining the draft code. Scotland's two main funeral trade associations are clear in their support of it, which underscores the collaborative spirit and shared commitment to our common goals. Research has shown that the vast majority of people incorrectly assume that minimum standards exist and that funeral directors are already subject to regulation. Worldwide, countries such as Canada, Australia, France, Spain, and many states in the USA, funeral directors are regulated, and many require both a personal and business licence to operate. In the UK, some headway is being made in the consumer protection space by the Competition and Markets Authority and the regulation of funeral prepayment plans by the Financial Conduct Authority. However, standards lag behind in relation to care of the deceased, which occurs in private areas of funeral director businesses. Whilst many funeral director businesses are already operating to a high standard, some departure from good practice has been identified. The provisions of the 2016 Act were largely based on the recommendations made by the Infant Cremation Commission, chaired by Lord Bonamy. This was convened in response to historical poor practice at a number of crematoriums across Scotland, details of which emerged in 2012. In addition, the National Cremation Investigation by Dame Eilish Angeloni in 2016 found that overall regulation of the funeral profession required improvement. Her final report recommended that the Scottish Government should exercise its powers under the 2016 Act to licence funeral directors and establish a statutory regime of regulation and inspection. More recently, an assessment of the industry has been strengthened by voluntary inspections undertaken by inspectors of burial, cremation and funeral directors and their investigations of complaints. The current lack of statutory regulation within the funeral sector poses a high level of risk. a minority of professionals can pose a threat due to poor practice, ill health or deliberate malevolence. I believe the implementation of a code is a vital step to safeguard the dignity and safety of the deceased. In turn, the code should go a long way to instill greater confidence in the funeral sector for the public and bereaved families. The draft code is the first significant step in the implementation of statutory regulation of funeral directors in Scotland. The CMA has recommended that England, Wales and Northern Ireland establish this type of statutory oversight in their own funeral sectors, and I am proud that Scotland is leading the way on this in the UK. The draft Funeral Director Code of Practice seeks to establish a baseline set of professional standards and quality assurance for funeral directors in Scotland. It is not intended to be a burden on businesses. The Scottish Government believes that the standards set out in the draft code not only protect the deceased and bring confidence to the public and the bereaved, but they will also benefit the funeral profession, contributing to the overall reputation of the industry and acknowledging the unique and challenging role that funeral directors play. I hope committee members agree that the draft code brings about positive changes to an important industry. With Parliament's support, I look forward to introducing the draft code in its final form to the industry. If approved by Parliament, funeral directors will be given a 12-month grace period to become fully compliant with the code's standards before the code would be formally issued by the Scottish Government and would come into force. I therefore move the motion and propose that the committee recommend that the draft of the Funeral Director Code of Practice be approved. I look forward to answering any further questions the committee may have. Thanks.
Thank you, Minister. Can I remind the committee that members should not put questions to the Minister during the formal debate. Officials may not speak in the debate, and I invite any members who wish to make a contribution to the debate to indicate now. I've had no indication that any member wishes to make a further contribution. Minister, do you wish to sum up?
I'm content. I think my opening statement covered what this code is intended to do, and I'd like to thank the committee for your consideration.
Thank you, Minister. The question is that motion S6M 11905 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? Thank you. The committee is agreed. Thank you, Minister. And that concludes consideration of the document. Our meeting next week will be held fully in private to continue consideration of a draft Stage 1 report on the National Care Service Scotland Bill. At our meeting on the 6th of February, we will be taking evidence from stakeholders as part of our post-legislative scrutiny of the Alcohol Minimum Pricing Scotland Act 2012. And that concludes the public part of our meeting today.